She, it's just a big root, a root she found, and with a tail on it. The root had a tail on it. And it turned out pretty good.
This carving was originally a piece of driftwood. It was created by the late Mrs. Sophie King. Sophie was born on Salt Spring Island in 1880. Bob purchased this collection of her folk art in 1976 and put it on display here at the Akerman Family Museum.
A lot of people come to see the museum and they're quite fascinated with the driftwood carvings. She did a lot of animals and birds and things, and this is a small deer that she carved from a piece of driftwood. She must have been carving about 20 years, I guess. People used to come from all over just to see her carvings. She was well known for her carvings. Like above my door there, there's a piece of bark there made into a swordfish. She did a lot of different things, like birds sitting in their nests, and top of the showcase there, that's all her carvings. And then the one up in the center there is Abraham Lincoln.
Sophie's mother, Sarah, was a Cowichan Indian, and her father, George Purser, was an Englishman. The family fell on hard times, and from 3 to 17 years of age, Sophie lived in a convent in the Cowichan Valley, where she was cared for and educated by the Sisters of St. Anne. After several years of domestic service work in Seattle and Victoria, she returned to Salt Spring. She met and married Leon King, who was of Greek and Aboriginal descent. Leon was a farmer, logger, fisherman, boat builder, and entertained islanders at dances with his violin, which he learned to play by ear. Together, they raised 6 children at their Beaver Point farm on the shores of King Cove near Ruckle Park.
She used to go down to the beach and pick up driftwood, and if it looked like a bird, she would work on it, or a fish, or animal, whatever she thought it looked like. She said, the last carving I made, she picked up a piece of driftwood and she brought it home, sat in front of a mirror, and she carved herself and what she thought she looked like. That's her last one. And it does look very much like her. If you see the picture, this is her picture, and that's what she thought she looked like. So she's very close.
To learn more about Sophie King and Salt Spring's unique history, visit the Salt Spring Archives online.